Hinduism is not a prescriptive religion, and therefore there are no commandments. There's no God out there telling you commandments. There is no universal Hindu rule which applies. Also, because Hinduism is highly diverse, it is designed around the caste system. Therefore, there are different communities who follow different attire depending on different parts of the country they live in, the ecosystems they lived in. So different fashions evolved. In ancient times in India, the upper part of the body was not covered at all. So women didn't cover their breasts. It was not considered to be obscene or vulgar. It was just the way people dressed. Therefore, on temple walls, when you see the images of the gods and goddesses, you will see the women don't cover the upper part of their body. But over time, the upper part of the body started being covered. So you have ekavastra, dvivastra, trivastra, lajjavastra, different kinds of things emerging. Finally, the sari emerging, which is a combination of the lower and upper garment, which covers both the lower part of the body and the upper part of the body, and gradually you have the ghungat emerging, which is the thing. And ghungat is more seen in the northern part of India than the southern part of India. Hinduism has always had a tension between the hermit school and the householder school. The hermit school has always looked at life in a very pessimistic, negative way. It looks at pleasures as seductive and temptations that will take you away from the Atma, while the householder school believed that only by engaging with the world and enjoying the pleasures of life do you actually come in touch with the Atma. And so therefore these two schools of thought have always been at loggerheads. So the householder school always celebrated flaunting the body. So it was part of Kama Shastra. You have to bedeck your body, adorn your body. The word Shringara, which means to adorn the body, to make it auspicious. So beauty and making yourself beautiful was not just a case for vanity. It was also to make yourself auspicious and to attract good fortune. So when you read Kalidasa's poetry, you will read poetry about women adorning themselves in places which is auspicious. The word is Mangalyam. Therefore, the gods and goddesses also offered clothes and cosmetics and jewelry. You don't find this in any other part of the world. The adornment of the deity is a very important part of Hinduism. Therefore, the adornment of the body, because our body is the temple of the Atma, you should adorn your body. So flaunting is a very part. This is a very important part of Indian traditions. And this idea of shame and the body associated with shame really comes from Abrahamic faiths, where the body was to be shamed because it takes you away from the wisdom and silence and piety, and sort of traps you in the material world of delusions. So the body was seen as the nymph that sort of takes away the sage from his meditation. That was the Indian thought. And then when Abrahamic thoughts came in, body was seen as sinful, associated with the devil and shame, and has to be covered all the time. The head has to be covered, the breast has to be covered. To be covered was considered holy. And you find this increasingly in parts of India, wherever Islam came. It's very interesting, like in North India, when you see where the Islam influence is fairly strong, women do wear ghungat covering the entire face. In South India also Islam has come, but in the Islamic community, in Kerala and in Lakshadweep, the women would still wear jewelry and flaunt their bodies, but they would cover their veil, the upper part of their heads. So there is this interesting mixture of the Indian way and the Islamic way, especially in the Malabar coast, that you find. So you do find these two different traditions emerging, one which says that flaunt your body, it's part of life, and the other which says be ashamed of your body, and body is the devil's creation and you should be ashamed of it. I think increasingly people are trying to institutionalize Hinduism. It has more to do with power than to do with faith. And God cares what you dress up as. And there'll always be people who will try to tell, especially women, what they should wear. And beware of such religious leaders.